Howdy folks, it's Glenn with the almost world famous Cactus Atlas, and today I'm filming at Dripping Springs, part of Oregon Mountains Desert Peaks National Monument, right outside of Las Cruces, New Mexico. That was a mouthful. And the first thing you notice as you pull up here into this parking lot are these mountains that just abruptly rise out of the desert. The Oregon Mountains, very craggly, very dramatic and beautiful. They also have like a visitor center over here. Not sure if it's open yet, but let's see if we can find a map. I have a map in my head, but I'd like a map to show you. So they have lots of brochures here that I'm taking advantage of, and here's really what we're doing today. We want to do this Dripping Springs trail, and I think we're going to be starting here. And really what we want to do is get all the way down here. So it's about 3 miles round trip, and there's some really cool stuff that we're going to see over here. A little bit of information about this trail, why I'm here. I recently discovered this online, and despite the beautiful scenery in these mountains, which is enough on its own, there's a lot of really interesting history, especially of that from the late 1800s, the 1860s, 1870s, and onward. And we're gonna see old buildings from that time frame, in addition to maybe some flowing water. One of the features here that people come to see are little waterfalls, but they haven't had any rain since March. So the gentleman told me you're not really gonna see much there. That's really not why I came. I came here more for the history and the scenery around it. But yeah, this should be a good one. I just keep stopping to take in this view, which also serves as an excuse to catch my breath. Because this smoke, man, I don't know if it picks it up really good on camera, but you can smell it in the views. Oh, the views. We have choices, but I know where I'm going. We're going to Dripping Springs. And the sanatorium is one thing I wanna see for sure. So we're gonna be going to the right. But this trail over here looks amazing, walking straight towards the mountains over there. We got some more signage going the right way, and giant mountains and historic structures, natural beauty and history, the perfect pairing. So this is the livery, and this was built by Eugene Van Patten. His mountain camp is only about a quarter of a mile left to go, but here's a picture. He would have a stagecoach or buggy that would run up here and bring guests, I think. So this is kind of a resort or something like that. But there's also a chicken coop. I'm gonna assume this is the chicken coop from the 1800s. You don't often see things this well preserved. Another structure here at the base of these big mountains. Thank you. These structures are so well preserved too. Reminds me a little bit about like Bodie in California. Some of the best preserved structures I've seen out in the Southwest, actually, like of this sort, wood. A lot of these things don't survive and burn down. So it's really fortunate when you find stuff like this. Hey, look, we saw these in Joshua Tree. I think these are a psychedelic plant. Isn't it datura or jimson weed? Is that what this is? Anyway, highly poisonous too, if that's what this is. We have a couple things we can check out. I'm gonna go to Dripping Springs first, and I may go try to seek out this Van Patten Mountain Camp second, but we'll go to the Sanatorium and Dripping Springs up this way, up by these mountains over here. These are easily some of the steepest, almost vertical faced mountains that I've seen on my journeys. The Oregon Mountains. I don't have to make note of it. I'm here. I'm gonna have to come back and explore more of this, because this is something. I knew it was gonna be cool, but I didn't know it was gonna be this good. It looks like we could go to Dripping Springs and the Van Patten Camp. Must be a loop. Goes down this way. You can see a lot of lush green. Evidence of a spring or some water source. But first, I want to see the sanatorium. This old relic, I think, from the 1800s. Oh, wow. So right around the corner, I'm encountering old buildings. I assume that's the sanatorium up there on the stilts. Here we are at the old sanatorium. What this actually is the dining hall and kitchen. Health seekers, as they describe them in the sign, would have stayed in tents. People that were probably sick trying to come here. So the sign mentions that health seekers came out to the sanatorium. If we're talking the 1800s, and I hear sanatorium and I hear the Southwest, I usually think of tuberculosis, because a lot of people would come out here for the drier climate, which would, in theory, relieve their symptoms. So I'm guessing this is probably a sanatorium mainly for people like that, but who knows? Maybe other illnesses or ailments, but I tell you what, if I were on my last legs dying, and despite wanting the relief that maybe the climate could provide, this scenery would be like a good place to spend your last days. I'm amazed at how well preserved a lot of this stuff is too. They didn't have dates on any of the signs, but reading on the internet, I think this is from the 1800s, the later 1800s. That is so cool. Now, I do see stairs here. So I'm assuming it's okay to go up and maybe see if we could see the remnants of the Dr. Boyd's house and get a closer look at this structure. Kind of discern what it's made of. I don't know what that material is on the outside. It almost looks like concrete of some sort or plaster. I don't know. They do have it where you can get a look inside of it. Once again, kind of hard to see with all this chicken wire. I know as I get closer to it, it's gonna focus on the wrong thing. But yeah, you can take a peek in there. That's cool. Let's go around this way. See if we could see anything else cool. It's kind of dark in there. Let's check this out. does feel like some kind of concrete. Here's another view. Trying to peek in there. Easier said than done. The dining hall and kitchen. I guess the way to go, there's more stairs back here. So this is neat. You could walk underneath the structure too, I think. Wasn't quite sure what we'd find back here, but lo and behold, the whole house is still standing. Dr. Boyd's house. Who was in a land dispute or a rent dispute or something with Van Patten, a homesteader in this area that I think owned the land. This guy apparently didn't want to pay us rent, but I wonder if there's a little bit of restoration on this thing, because some of that wood looks a little too new to be original, but who am I to say? And there's the chimney. Usually on my adventures, the chimney is all that's left of structures like this. So it's such a treat to be able to see a intact structure like this. Some old concrete here. Mr. Boyd, does your spirit reside here still? I wish I could get a better look in there. There are trails that go all around this thing and really giving you a good glimpse of these gigantic mountains back here, towering over this stuff. Man, so if you like history and natural beauty, this place might be, I think this place is next level when it comes to that. This is fantastic. I tell you what. Wow. And there's a collapsed structure back there. Decaying. Not sure what that was. You know, if you come visit here, be sure to take the trail behind there and see the Dr. Boyd's house and the other stuff. I noticed other folks are coming up here and checking this out, which is awesome on its own, but yeah, behind there's some really neat stuff as I showed you. Anyway, let's go find this Van Patten Mountain Camp. I'm pretty sure that's the spring dripping down. I can see it dripping. It's hard to see, probably or impossible to see on camera, and I hear people down there, but there's some kind of man-made structure. So we're gonna head down there. I hear people hiking, so almost certain that's the spring. You know, in life, some things are love at first sight. Some places are love at first sight, and that's this place for me. I am very drawn to this. Man, I wish I could live out here. I would totally go back in time and take the inconveniences of the time, not to live at the sanatorium, of course, but just to be out here, away from it all, out on the frontier. Although there was a lot of murder and bad things that happened in this area, as we're gonna find out, but that aside, okay, so I was right. This is the dripping spring, or springs, and you really can't see. I think it flows a lot heavier at different times of the year if it rains or if there's snow melt. You can see a little bit of water. It's kind of hard with the sun there, but it is dripping, like quite literally. Apparently I'm going against the grain. I think most people are doing the loop the opposite direction that I'm doing. This, I believe, takes us to the mountain camp. I think I already found it, so it's not far. More historic structures to check out. Hoorah! Oh yeah, this is awesome. You can see a lot of old foundations and actually intact structures back here. This trail kind of winds back this way. And there are no signs saying that you can't go this way. So I assume it's okay. Another particular about their historic preservation, which I love. But yeah, look at this. There's a sign that'll tell us what this is, I think. But yeah, all of this like built up against these like cliffs. That is fantastic. How did they do this? back then. You know, this would be an awesome place to cool off in the summer back here in between the house. I mean, the roof goes right up as close as it can get. So what we're looking at here, this mountain camp, Van Patten's mountain camp, is an old resort that catered to a lot of the social elite at the time and students that were studying agriculture in New Mexico. This was a getaway spot. I thought it was going to be like a mining camp, but it's not. It's a old 1800s, late 1800s resort. Now, it doesn't say what the buildings are, but this one's fantastic. I was poking around in here, looking inside, and you can still see original wallpaper flaking off the walls. Very much like Bodie, very well preserved. I'll see if I can poke in here and show you. It's gonna be really hard, but maybe we can do it. Yeah, there you go, you see that? That's original wallpaper, I believe, on the walls. How cool is that? And this has that like concrete, maybe it's stucco of some sort. I'm gonna just call it that, I think. It's really hard as a rock. So, not like the stucco on my modern home. This is like built to last. Except right there. There's a big hole. But you can see this is made of stone, so the wall is made of stone. Just like that, right behind us. You can still see some of the plaster or stucco on the front of the walls. So imagine you remove all the stucco here and you just be left with a stone wall, like that. Look at the gutters also. We got those like wooden supports, kind of southwestern looking. And then you've got like those rusty old pipes, the gutters that would have drained the rain. When I take into account the preservation factor, being able to see what appears to be old wallpaper on the walls, like you could see in Bodie, California. I keep mentioning Bodie, so yes, we've made a video there and you should check that out too. Link in the description, but anyway, like when I see stuff like that, that really gets me excited. And like the buildings here are second to none. If you wanna see old wooden 1800 structures in really good shape, this is the place, man, for real. And these are fantastic too. They're roofless, but the stone walls are so well preserved. I would have loved to have stayed here and just look up. Bum, bum, bum. Wow. That is something. To me, this is heaven. This, like the ill feelings I'm getting from the bad air, are all just washing away now. I'm standing in the middle of this resort. I just feel like a general sense of well-being taking over me, like a connection, you know? It's hard to describe. I just feel a connection to this place. That's the best way I can describe it. And there's butterflies flying around me. It's too perfect. Alrighty folks, that was the Dripping Springs Trail. We saw history, we saw dramatic scenery, the best I've seen in 2022, for sure. This is at the top of my list. I loved it. the history is as well preserved as Bodie, California at some point. So if you're into that, it's worth doing it. If you want to see dramatic mountains that rival like things you'd see in Zion National Park, this place has got it all. I'm going to come back because we didn't do everything, but I got to hit the road. See you next time.